team Ad Finem. Really excited to be checking this one out. Both of these teams kind of in the spotlight a little bit. Team Secret, obviously, the little bit of things, which doesn't have to do with their in-game performance, but a lot of controversy surrounding them recently. Ad Finem just got knocked out of the Summit as well. So both of these teams trying to, you know, move past a couple of things that didn't go their way recently and focus now on the here and now, which is the Dota Pit EU qualifiers for Season 5. CC&C, how are you doing today? You excited to watch this match?
Yeah, it should be a good one. Just a sandwich, some water, go.
Yeah, me too.
You dotes.
Great.
Sandwich too?
I had a bagel and cream cheese, a little bit of coffee. It's noon, but that's fine. We're still going to be watching some great Dota 2. I'm excited. Have you gotten to watch many of these teams' games recently?
Yeah, I watched most of the best of five in the Summit that Ad Finem have. I haven't seen too many Secret games lately. Yeah, I've seen some of Ad Finem play. They've been looking good.
Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting. Recently, we talked about this, just touched on it briefly, the big blog that went off. Obviously, there's been a lot of people that have been making memes about it, but as far as their actual performance, Team Secret have been looking really good. And I think that as a team, the only reason I really bring it up is because sometimes I feel like when controversy surrounds you, you kind of group together. You have a team dynamic that's like, all right, let's pull through this. Let's just go in, bust it out, work hard, and make things happen. And it feels like that's what they're doing so far today, even. And the past couple of days, they've been playing in the Face It League qualifier. They beat Escape Gaming. They beat Team Empire. And they just 2-0'd Vega Squadron, who qualified for the Summit. So... Or excuse me, not Vegas going to qualify for the Summit, that's BP. But Vegas Squadron been looking good as well. They've been doing a lot of stuff, but they beat them 2-0. So I've been impressed by their play so far. I'm curious to see how they go from here.
Yeah, for sure. You typically either, whenever heavy criticism comes in, you either collapse and play like garbage, or you step up and play really well. So they've been doing the latter, it seems. But
yeah. And then on the other side, Ad Finem, they've been kind of going through a bit of a rough spot themselves. They were able to beat out Virtus Pro in the Summit qualifiers 2-1 about 3 days ago. And then just yesterday, they lost to them 3-1 going the other way. So a little bit unfortunate there. They're able to beat out this team, had to face them again later on in the qualifiers, and then lost to them. But so far, it looks like they're going to be going back to their IO Juggernaut strategy. And man, IO just, I feel like this hero is never going to leave the competitive scene. Always relevant.
Yeah, it's just sort of the concept, being able to save heroes from really far away, turn fights around with the regen, the extra movement speed, all that stuff. He can farm stacks, he can stack a lot of camps at once with the spirits. Just sort of the concept of the hero is like hard to be bad.
Yeah, totally. I mean, and that's the thing, is like, you get into this situation now where you are, you know, getting map control at some point in time, and you basically just dominate the game. Do you think that we'll see the IO and Juggernaut go together? Like, is that a lane that seems strong to you if they want to run that mid potentially?
It sort of depends on what the other heroes are. Wisp typically like decides what lane he's going to. As you sort of like figure out where people are headed, where like he can help out the most. You know, if he needs to land in the safe lane with the jug, or if he's going to dual lane mid, if like they have kill potential there with the extra movement speed and the spin. It sort of depends on what they pick, what their hero is, stuff like that. Wow, that's an opener.
All right, they did it again. This is something I was wondering if we were going to see it. A little bit earlier on today, I believe that they ran this draft as well. So, tell me what you think about Pudge. Puppy was playing it earlier, and I'm assuming he's going to be roaming on it again.
I mean, I think Pudge is a good hero. The dismember changes, where you get the extra where you get the HP regen, and then it gives like or does more damage. Like the, I don't know, the hero, like the ability to just like pull somebody like across the map. It's like, I don't know, it's like very game changing. The hero is like hit or miss, and you know, if you're Cupe, then you know, just win every game. But yeah, the hero is definitely good now. He's good at roaming. Rod is like ridiculous in like early fights and stuff. Just a pain to deal with. He makes you play differently. Any hero that does that, it's like is typically going to be pretty good, because whenever you have to play differently, it makes mistakes happen. When mistakes happen, game gets easy.
Absolutely. That's what they're hoping to be able to accomplish here. I mean, normally when I've been seeing him recently, it's been in response to something like a Kunkka or a Faceless Void where you pull them out of the Chronosphere. This is kind of another, you know, BKB piercing disabled Juggernaut thought to be very safe hero because you've got that untarget ability with Blade Fairy, but Pudge kind of mitigates that and causes some trouble as well. The Legion Commander going to be banned out as well as the Faceless or the Lifestealer and Undying. What do you think about that Undying ban? We've been seeing more of them, but it seems like an interesting one.
Yeah, I know at Venom Life stuff like that a lot. Skylark plays that they do some like aggressive lanes. It's pretty good with the Wisp because you can like rotate in, give the Undying extra moves and speed, run people down. You can extra heal people with Soul Rip. And it's just like a hero like Ad Phenom likes to play. It seems like they're banning sort of comfort heroes. They banned Thug's Puck. He's like one of the only players that still plays that hero and does pretty well on it. So it seems like they're just sort of like banning comfort heroes, stuff like that.
Yeah, well, and Keeper of the Light, now the answer that Ad Phenom go to. This hero, to me, is also kind of taken on a new life. All of the changes to Chakra Magic that sort of occurred slowly over time. One of the things that people don't talk about a ton is that not only now do you get the mana increase, but you can actually top somebody off above their full mana pool, and it just adds to the overall mana pool. So something like a Jug Spin, if you cast it out, you can still end the spin with full mana afterwards. But the other big change was the Blinding Light recently changed around, and now it's this like huge AoE. Have you actually seen it when it's getting used?
Yeah, it's pretty insane.
Do you think that's enough to like sort of mitigate the nerfs that came to Mana Leak?
I don't know, like the Mana Leak nerfs, what did the cast range at level 4 get nerfed, or was it the same?
I think it's the same, it's just that the cooldown and the mana cost was increased, if
that's
I'm not
right,
mistaken.
That's right, the mana cost got jacked up a whole lot. I mean, it makes them worse at like laning versus heroes like Timbersaw and stuff, where you just like press W on them a whole lot. And then they can't do that much. You sort of like walk them down or force them to walk out the lane, and then they can't like stay in the lane anymore. So it like makes them weaker in lane, but I think he's still a good hero. You know, like in the situations he is good. Just like makes you, it forces you to play him like a little differently. If they have really strong lanes, then he maybe becomes less viable. It's a good nerf, I think. It doesn't like make him super useless. It just makes him more niche and. He isn't like a jack of all trades now, where he just like zones people with like 42 damage because Mana Leak's a retarded spell.
It's a tough one to deal with, certainly. Tidehunter now also going to be the pick for Team Secret. They're running pretty low on the reserve time, as well as the Sven, so that natural just like big team fight dynamic, getting a whole hell of a lot of net worth on the Sven. And then Timbersaw is the answer. This seems like it's really good. Three melee strength heroes. It's like a great game for Timber.
Yeah, this is oh, Storm. Wow. Yeah, mid one really, really likes that hero. They pick it a lot for him.
Mm-hmm.
This is also like actually such a good Storm game. Holy cow, this is such a good Storm game.
I mean, does the mana leak start to bother him at all? Is that something that you need to be at least a little concerned about, or not really?
Not really, because it doesn't drain your mana when you're zipping, so like that's what most of your movement is. It's a little annoying in early skirmishes, but later on in the game, like their supports are so squishy that like the Storm, once he gets some items, he just like jumps this Caudle and Io, and they just die every fight, and there's almost nothing they can do about it.
Yeah, that really hurts. And obviously, you don't want to get to that position as Ad Phenom. They've got heroes that give them a lot of map vision and will allow them to sort of hopefully get a little bit of a holdover secret and not allow that. But it does feel like vision to me is kind of the most important thing here. You've got Storm Spirit being able to spot people and then jump on them. Pudge obviously wanting to find hooks, and then the Io relocates. Do you think Ad Phenom looks to a hero that can give him some of that in this last pick, or is it just more about rounding out the team fights?
Maybe. I'm not sure. They need
an offlaner, probably.
Yeah, probably an offlaner. This isn't really... I mean, Timbersaw could go offlane in this game. I'm not really sure what they're looking for. Bug plays some, like, odd heroes a lot of the time. They're sort of lacking on catch, this Timbersaw. So, yeah, if they are picking an offlaner, maybe, like, Beastmaster, they can just put in the jungle, maybe a Slaughter's Band. Yeah, I don't know. Nyx Span, Sanking Span, there's not really a lot of offlaners left. There's like Clockwork, but Clockwork's pretty awful versus Storm. They need some sort of answer for the Storm. They need a stun, so it's probably... I mean, if Beastmaster, it's probably some like, yeah. Beastmaster sounds alright.
Oh! Alright!
Okay, so it's the Magic Hero. They're gonna run at some buildings.
Alright, they said screw your Storm shirt, we're just gonna take all your buildings. I like this response, it's cool.
Yeah, that's one of Storm's biggest weaknesses. Sables aren't actually that good versus Storm if you can't, like, take control of the map. You can't take his towers, because otherwise, you know, you kill him, you take some gold from him, but he just goes and farms jungle, he still gets his core items, and eventually he's going to start killing you, even if you have disables, because he's just going to jump a bunch of heroes at the same time. It's sort of like the Alchemist effect, where you really, like, killing him is nice, but you really want to take his buildings, and they also, like, you know, like I said, Thug plays weird heroes. Like, he plays Puck and Shakiro. Those are, like, his signature heroes, so...
Well, cool stuff. I'm excited to see how this ends up working out. We've got Ad Finem facing off against Secret again. This is a double elimination tournament, so the loser of this series will not necessarily be out, but certainly a good way towards it if they're not careful. And the inaugural pause that happens at the start of every Dota game, we're not going to break that tradition here. The GLHFs come out. Who are you favoring in this?
Except Brown.
My God. Oh, poor mid one. Oh no.
Got him.
I do like this. Everybody seems friendly. That Finem guy seems like, I don't know. They seem like they should be characters in Animal House or something like that. You know what I mean?
You get what I mean at all? Yeah, I know what you mean. These guys are they're pretty crazy. They're very like charismatic and I don't know, they're just like whenever they were there at the summit, like they're so loud, actually insane. You could hear them from like across the house, and they're playing pops. Ah, da, da. They're played Mafia with them a couple of times. They're really really fun guys.
That's awesome. I love to see that. You know, good excited behavior when people are playing Dota. None of the seriousness. It's all about fun. At the end of the day, we're playing video games, ladies and gents. Let's have fun while we do it. Follow the Greek example. And speaking of. Oh, and the Greeks looks like they're going to be moving in, trying to catch MP. If he turns to stun, might end up going down. Madara thought about diving for that one, but they're just going to back out and secure themselves a rune.
Yeah, they didn't really have a way to get on top of him. Sort of waltzes away.
Nice and easy. And it looks like they will be securing the rune for somebody. Do you like one person over, like, is it just give the rune to the Io and Lemge's bottle? I guess not.
Not with the items he's going. It looks like he's doing the no quick bottle builds where he buys like a bunch of random regen and stuff. I'm not really an IO expert. Not sure like when and when not you do those things, when and when not you go for the fresh bottle or not. But Spartan knows his wisp, so I trust him.
All right. Well, and early on, it's going to be the Jakiro versus the Storm Spirit in the mid lane. Liquid Fire, it's really great against a hero like a DK or something. What do you think about it against, like, a Storm Spirit?
Like, level 1, level 2, it's fine for Storm. You know, you can use Remnant and stuff. the Selene is, you know, both heroes farm. The only time, like, issues will arise for the Storm is if the Jakiro outplays him early on, and the Storm can't really get to his bottle quick enough, and the Jakiro gets to a point where we can start zoning him with Dual Breath, Liquid Fire harassing him down. But mid one, got all this. Oh, he missed one, but he did pretty well that first wave, so he should end up being fine. Slain will just basically break even, because you can always just farm and push out the lane with the Remnant.
Yeah, it's really nice, that little... I mean, that's the reason why Storm's still around all the time, is good laning potential, and already dealing a good bit of damage to Thug. Be a little bit careful here. It doesn't take too much more. Mid one, definitely an accomplished Storm Spirit player, and it's just going to get up in the face of Thug for a little while here. What about a couple of these other lanes? It is going to be the Coddle with the Timber Saw, so a tremendous amount of burst damage as Coddle gets later levels. Do you think that the Sven Oracle has enough to deal with them?
Early on, they should be okay. The Sven's going to farm, but if this Timber Saw gets like free reign, starts getting some levels, this may start getting hairy for them, because they don't really have a way to kill this Timbersaw once he gets like 2, maybe he goes 3 in reactive armor and does the old sit under the tower and don't take damage thing. As the lane gets further in, they may need to get rotations from the Pudge. He did the pull thing, so he's already level 2. Midway, that's some clowny stuff. But.
Oh, nicely done there by Puppy. Yeah, getting that full connection as well, so he's going to be able to take down those camps. Man, talk about efficiency. Captain knows what's up. Meanwhile, over there towards the jungle, Frev's just been running around trying to get whatever he can from the lane. There was a pull that went off to the medium camp as well. So they were able to get a good amount of experience. And now a regen run picked up by Storm as well. Man, I think that Secret are pretty happy with this early start.
That is the worst feeling ever. You know, you pass somebody down, you focus your whole lane on getting them low, and they find a regen run, and your lane is over.
Yeah. Definitely. Oh, and not to mention the fact that now you're also dealing with the wave being pulled against you by the Pudge. He got the deny off after finishing off a lot of that experience there. Guys, if you are looking how to play Pudge support, this is a pretty good game to watch what Puppy's been doing. So it is definitely feeling like they're off to a good start because of him.
Fills his bottle too. What a nice guy.
Oh, man. What a guy. Now moving in towards mid, level 3 already. Could apply a little bit of damage here to Thug. Pump fakes the hook, not going to go for it as of yet. Still does hold on to it, but yeah, just trying to zone out and give mid 1 an easier time in the mid lane. He always helping out his teammates.
Classic come mid and sit there and just pump flake a lot.
He did miss that one hook. Bottom lane, Frev taking a little bit of damage as well. But yeah, they're good for the moment.
Yeah, Ferev's got to be pretty careful. If he does overextend a little bit, he can get run down pretty easily by the spin. Once the jug is level 5, like, he'll die every single time to the spin with the wisp balls, because he does have level 2 balls. He didn't get overcharged at level 3. So he's 1-2-0, so they have a lot of damage. If the side ever overextends, he's going to get spun on and whacked.
Yeah, that is a ton of damage. You start to think about all 5 of those connected, and then afterwards you get the spin on top of them. It is a real struggle indeed. Thug went for the double null tally build, just going to try and mess with mid 1 to the best of his abilities. And I feel like this is the point where the lane really starts to become more difficult, because you've got like maximum points, the cooldown liquid fire starts to get into almost unreasonable levels, and it's a struggle.
Yeah, those early pulls are helping out mid 1 a lot, mostly because of the XP. The mid 1's going to hit level 6 a little earlier than the Chikiro, so there isn't really that much kill potential. Typically there'd be like a level where you have to be pretty careful as a Storm, and you can get killed if you get harassed down quite a bit. But since he's a little ahead on levels, he should be able to get to his level 6 fine and just farm or whatever. And if the lane ever gets to a point where the Chikiro starts to harass him out of the lane, then you can just go to jungle. But one of the biggest things about this matchup that's like good for Storm in the course of the game is that Chikiro really wants to push down this lane and try and like pressure the tower early on. That's sort of like the only thing the hero is good at. And Storm just like shoves your wave over and over again, so you never really get a chance to go to the tower. And so it's sort of like it's really ends up like in the course of the game being really good for the Storm. So.
Right. Well, we'll see if they can maybe bring somebody in to try and make something happen. I guess they've also got the problem as, you know, Pudge is eventually going to be able to roam around. They do ping out and realize that mid 1 is in the area, and this is Cottle moving in as well. Does have a ability to ramp up and go for an Illuminate Blast, but well, does this this might be a good bit of damage against mid 1, brought down fairly low, but we'll be able to walk away.
Yeah, they just showed they have the ward there, though, so I don't know if that was worth it.
Yeah. That's a good point. Well, Puppy in the meantime. I mean, nobody's really in the area to try and deward it, I guess, as well as they're going to try and chase down Ferev. Ball's not going to hit him and do enough damage. So it looks like the Madara is going to have to get out of there, taking some damage as well. Oh. Salve has to reapply. That'll be fine.
Yeah. Ferev skilled the gush, Puppy.
Oh my god, mid 1. This is frustrating, I'm sure. Get another regen rune in lane as he hits his level 6. Doesn't miss any CS off the back of that and still keeps a hold of that regen.
Using your mana, don't let it run out.
No.
And meanwhile, off to the side, MP getting chased down as well. They're going to try and timber chain forward for this. Misses the chakram, and yeah, I think that they're going to have to call off the charge.
Yeah. Yeah, mid 1's been like sort of moving around a fair bit. TP's there, so this mid tower has actually taken a decent amount of damage. He rotated to the jungle whenever the Chikiro had some levels and the supports are missing because he didn't want to feed. But he did lose like half HP in the tower, so maybe he wants to commit more to the lane now. Or get another hero to come and kill this Jakiro. Killing heroes that are relying on like taking early towers or getting an early lead is just massive.
Yeah.
He also did go for more of the killing skill build. He went 204 instead of more points in Remnant before Overload, so looking to get into early fights probably. It looks like he's going Treads before the Soul Ring as well, so yeah, really looking to fight early on.
It kind of does make sense, is like you're going to have to deal with this pressure that's coming your way. So, oh, the jump in actually going to be able to find Thug. The Remnant hits onto him and looking for the kill, needs one more zip, and that's going to be a kill onto Thug. First Blood, though, actually went to Forever in the bottom lane. So, Jakiro able to stay alive long enough to not feed First Blood.
Yeah, he dodged both the Liquid Fires. That was huge.
And one.
If he had gotten his attack speed slowed, he might have gotten, might have not had enough time to get the overload off, got hit by the tower a couple times and died. Because he did barely live, like 60 HP or something, the Liquid Fire ticks. Or the, Dual Breath.
Well played. Yeah, and I guess that's the thing with Jakiro, is that you do just deal all of that damage over time. So if you happen to, relocate in, Puppy in some trouble, the solo gank, and gets the deny on the creep. Man, value and a half for that Wisp. Nicely played.
Why is no TP? You might actually get him.
Yeah, in some trouble. While I die, in some trouble. Whoa. Is going to go down to that Caudal Blast. Unfortunately, the Timber Chain not going to be able to allow Skylark to escape. And so mid one finds another kill. 2-0 start for the Storm. Not bad at all, but it is going to come at the cost of his tower.
Yeah. For Jakiro, that tower is going to go down. It's just sort of how it goes. Typically want to punish the Jakiro whenever he tries to do stuff like that, maybe kill him, but he does get the kill in the Storm, so it's not terrible for Secret, because that's how, you know, it's a Jakiro, that's what the hero does.
Right. No, definitely. And I mean, in the meantime also, like, they'll be able to start defending the rest of these towers too. You have Ravage up on the Tidehunter, and it looks like Thug is going to move down bottom. They want to try and pressure this here. Aquila turned on, and a 4-second cooldown on that Liquid Fire is going to drop it very rapidly. The spin forward, cutting the creep wave. We'll see if Ferev should be able to pull it past. So they'll do some damage to this, but with the fortification and everything else, it might be a little bit tough for them to actually bring it down.
Yeah, they have the healing ward. The Storm's a little low on mana. They're sort of not okay. in a place where they want to fight right now. The Storm has to go back to base, fill up this bottle. The Sven doesn't have, like, Blink, doesn't have Treads, Echo Save, or nothing, so even though they have Ravage, it's sort of hard for them to take fights right now. This is where Ad Venom needs to, like, take a lot of control of the game using...
Is that going to be a kill up top? Oh my god, what's happening?
TP.
Yeah, right. Able to escape. Sorry about that, folks. Meanwhile, jumping in, going after the Spartan. Maybe going to be able to find the kill and follow up on Madara as well. Ferev just walking away from this Juggernaut. Pops the Ravage as well, and that's going to be a kill for the overextension. Nicely played.
Yeah, that was really nice. Mid one healing up, being there just the right time. Ferev baiting them in. And now just sort of a little too deep. Madara with no TP, so no way to get out with the spin TP and sort of get wrecked there.
Well, Caudal in the meantime, maybe next time, I would imagine that him getting an Ag Scepter is eventually going to be, like, really important for their push towards high ground, if that's what they're looking for in a while. How much do you need to emphasize his farm? Or do you think you need to?
I think it's... Oh, close.
You're actually going to go for it. We'll have to hold that.
Another region or what?
Oh my god, mid one.
Happening.
In the meantime, Io able to kill the Oracle bottom lane. I don't know, this game feels very chaotic to me. They're all over the place.
Yeah, whenever you... Oh, the heck? Gracious. Storm gets the 10.
Maybe gonna be able to find the kill onto MP as well. No, not gonna be able to get it.
Alright. Well, but yeah, like, whenever you have heroes like a Jakiro that's really not going to take up that much farm, you typically want one of your supports to be able to soak up some farm, but it's like, as of now, they just want to group up and take these towers, which is definitely not a bad play. Because this is sort of their timing where, you know, I think Ravage, yeah, Ravage is still on cooldown. They're able to just take these towers for free and get this early lead because that's what they're playing for. It's the only time their lineup is good, just, you know, battling early and often. That's...
Yeah. They do take it down at the end of the day. A little bit of lag coming through on the server. Exactly sure what that was about, but nonetheless, it looks like they're going to be able to keep these lanes pushed out fairly consistently. And with Relocate available on the IO, they could go for a play against the Oracle, who's alone in the mid lane, trying to get vision, but yeah, they're not going to go for it. A little bit too scary to dive for that.
Yeah, mid one could have TP'd in, probably turned the gank around, and things turned grim pretty quickly.
Out top. Not going to go for anything either there. It's been a very weird game so far. It feels like... I mean, Adfinim obviously wanting to get very aggressive. They want to try and take down these towers. But by the same token, it's almost like they're feeling a little bit afraid to dive in. But the relocate's going to come. They have Ferev. Omni Slash used. Ravage to turn it back around. Really well timed. Just a little bit short there on the hook. And in the meantime, the rest of Secret is grouped up and ready to find a counterplay. They jump in, find Madara. There's the pull. That is going to be the blinding light away. A ton of damage thrown out nonetheless. And Oracle gets the kill. Skylark, timber chaining around. He's stuck onto a tree. Very weird stuff coming out there. And Chakra Magic almost able to kill off Rev. Not quite going to be there. And they are going to be able to take down Skylark, I believe. Well, still very tanky. The Ice Path goes out. Is not going to connect onto Rev. It just got Kraken shelled off, I guess. That was really weird looking. There were some weird particle effects going on. I'm not sure what's going on with Dota right now.
Yeah, that was interesting. The Timber Saw was just like walking around with holding the tree.
Yeah, I guess that's what happens when you get the cooldown reduction with Chakra Magic. It sort of displays two of them at the same time. Oh, they found Puppy. I don't know if they can kill him though. Slow dual breath? Not gonna happen.
MP. While that was happening, got quite a bit of damage on the mid tower. Has his Echo Saber now, getting closer to his blink, so they're sort of getting closer to critical mass. The Storm has Bloodstone, actually. He is only 600 away from Bloodstone at 14 minutes with treads, so plenty of good timing for him.
Yeah, he's had a great one so far. In the meantime, it looks like they're going to recall in the Timbersaw. Now the full team there, they spin immediately. Mid one can't jump onto that jug. Left alone for the moment, they are going to throw out the Ice Path, dissuading the TP from coming in. Tower already dead. Mid one potentially going to take some more damage. They have another Chakra Magic if they want to use it. Blinding Light pushback doesn't do much damage with that debuff onto him, and unfortunately the hook is not going to connect onto heroes. Only takes one of those creeps. So, a little bit of a scary situation now. All this mobility coming out from Adfinim, they can keep on the aggression.
Yeah, they're just gonna keep pushing their advantage.
Spartan? He's stuck up on the high ground. I don't know if they realize this, though. He does have eyes on Puppy. Alright, and the hook's not gonna connect. They're starting to spend out the spirits. Stun? Dodged? Still fine.
Yeah, Secret really doesn't have a hero like a Medusa or a, you know, a Timbersaw of their own. You know, someone to like just sit on the front line and, oh, hello.
Maybe next time. Gonna get saved at the last second by Spartan. Meanwhile, they've been able to control Skylark. Ravage comes out, connects onto four, and now Secret are gonna start rolling mid one out of mana. They need to get a little bit more to find a kill here onto the IO, and it actually looks like Jug is gonna go back in. A very bold move for him indeed, and he ends up dropping. The relocate did not come quite in time. It would have been a really good play if they could have found it, but at the end of the day, Thug's going to get controlled and killed off, I believe. And with Io coming back into him, they're going to be able to take down Spartan as well. Oh, man, that really hurts. The Juggernaut going for the spin and tried to get relocated out at the last second, but had enough damage to bring him down first.
Yeah, that was a disaster. The Wisp tried to save the Caudle early on, but that huge Ravage hitting four, the Storm just sort of picked off the Timbersaw. He overextended a little bit. got him with the Echo Saber, God Strength, and they like evaporated like two heroes. The Jahir, like, once again, the hero is like good at taking towers, and in these like very organized fights, he's good where he can press a lot of his spells. His team sort of play around him. He's his tanky hero, or whatever, with like spells that disable people. Whenever you have heroes like Storm, like Tide, like Sven, that are really good at jumping in and blowing up heroes, causing chaos. He's not very good at those kinds of fights because he just can't really get his spells off. A lot of slippery heroes, a lot of disables, and his team just sort of falls around him, and then he gets run down.
Yeah, no, it's a real problem. And I mean, mid one, like you were talking about earlier, it's a great game for a Storm Spirit. The fact that their main disable at this point is Ice Path is really showing. The only like problem that they're having is like mid one running out of mana. And it is some small blessing for Adfinim that he didn't have his Bloodstone on him at the start of that fight, because he would be at 17 charges now. And honestly, the way these fights are going, it might happen anyways.
Yeah, he also has an Arcane rune, so it seems mid one is cheating on the runes. Three regents and an Arcane rune.
Yeah. I love this ward here, though, by Adfinim. Really good stuff.
Yeah, they have some serious vision on their side of the map. Gracious.
That's great. And looking... I kind of feel like Adfinim are thinking about going for a relocate gank, but a lot of secret are grouped together. So it might be a little bit difficult for them to actually find somebody.
Did they see that smoke or not? I'm not sure.
Yeah, I don't know if they did either. I don't think that they did. And now with Puppy leading the charge, if they're able to find somebody here, this would be huge. And the first person forward, they jump immediately onto, maybe next time, on the Coddle on the other side of the fight. Looks like that is going to be the Puppy Pudge trying to chase down the Juggernaut. Madara takes him down instead. And meanwhile, mid one looking for the catch, looking for the kill. This is going to be able to spin TP out of there, and no great way to escape. Meanwhile, the IO, did he relocate into that? Oh, he's going to be able to get back out. I think he's Gonzo. Trying to go for the TP.
Oh, that was close. That was really close.
That was really close. A little off, unfortunately.
Yeah, he's tried that twice and messed up both times.
Wow.
The Coddle actually got off his blast before the storm pulled him. So the Sven had to blink on him to stun him, cancel his TP. So it ended up buying enough time for the Jug to be able to get the Pudge kill and spin and walk away. So good one, not quite getting the pull off in time, and the Jug living because of that.
He is heading back in, and they actually have eyes on him. He does need to be careful. The quick stun, and Madara goes down. Oh, you kind of got to know that they're in your jungle.
Gosh.
And now, on the other side, able to jump on him maybe next time. He's going to drop also. Mana leaked, but should still go down. They do find the hook. And I think he got Bloodstone charges to that one as well. Yeah, mid one is going to be a force to be reckoned with.
Yeah, and now the secret's sort of gotten past that timing where Adfinim walks around and takes all their towers.
Oh, thug, mid lane. What are you doing there, buddy? Hook pulls him in, dealing a good bit of damage. Ice Path, Ravage dropped onto his dome. Skylark is there as well. The rest of the secret should be moving in, and well, the relocate's going to keep the Jakiro alive. So Ravage used for not a whole lot, as mid one wasn't in position in time.
Yeah, he was really low, man. I don't know if they realized that, but...
Madara's TPing in. Alright.
Looks like they had some conflicting ideas. The Wisp relocated back in, and then he got Coddle pulled back to base, and then he TP'd back in, so... Bouncing around there a little bit, but...
Ooh, an MP getting his farm on. You love to see that. You should, continue to accelerate. Already at 11,000 net worth, and looking like they want to try and go for a play. They're able to hook in Madara. Nicely done there. Frev, no Ravage available, but still taking some damage. Mid one jumps forward, gets the pull now onto the Jakiro. Ice Path gonna control, but that's all they got. Three already dead. Adfinim are all gonna drop. Oh man, and just like that, I mean, you've got Timbersaw who's trying to make his escape, but that was just never gonna happen. Ends up committing suicide, 5-20. Mid one is on a roll.
That is 20 charges. They it made it past that Venom's timing where they walk around and take the buildings, and now, like, you know, they just jump different targets. Sven jumped the backline, Storm jumped, I forget who, but, you know, they just kill a couple of heroes at once, and then, you know, the Advent just gets run down because they have all these stuns, they have all these disables, ways to jump in, and they have no way to kill the Storm. It's just actually not possible at this point. He has 20 Bloodstone charges.
Oh, man. Oh, this game is definitely going to be mid ones to win or lose, depending upon how he plays it. And so far, definitely been playing towards the former. I mean, it's just become so hard to play against us at this point. You talked about it earlier. The Coddle, the IO, you've got Blinding Light to keep him back, sort of. Can they mount another aggressive around, like, the Coddle Ags and maybe itemize to try and mess with the Storm Spirit?
I don't really know if there's a way they can, like, play aggressively anymore. I think they just have to try and, like, get as much farm as they can, like, defend their towers, and like, sort of counter-initiate on moves, because I don't know if there's, like, ever a way that they, like, I don't know, this Jakiro needs, like, a Hex and a Blink and, like, something that does damage, and maybe they kill Storm, but otherwise he's never dying, I'm pretty sure.
And in the meantime, Ferev was just swimming in the river. Madara runs right by MP. A little bit of action down here towards the bottom lane, and it looks like the Sven's going to jump out of there. Could have gone pretty terribly for Secret.
Yeah, he's up to a BKB now, so...
Oh man, Skylark might be dead as well. Puppy has the hook. Oh! He wanted it. He wanted it in a bad way. Storm Spirit's still there as well. If they wanted to go for the long-range jump, they definitely could, but the rest of Ad Finem is showing up, and...
Rev's going in.
Yeah? He's not afraid. Tidehunter. Got Greaves. He has Drums on the Tide already?
Yeah, he went first item Drums, I think, and then into the Greaves afterwards, so... He's a very rich fish.
Absolutely. Yeah, he's doing backflips in the river a little bit earlier, and I'm very happy with himself. I think Secret think this one is one for themselves, and man, with the Orchid available as well, Storm can just jump on any of these heroes, cause problems.
What do you think about those taunts, the moving taunts, the Tide one, the, you know, the SF one, the
Lion? Oh, it's all great. It's
really,
wonderful.
You like those? Man, I hate those things so much. They're so annoying, dude.
Do you see them a lot from the enemy team? Is that... I don't know. Anyways.
And it's like back in the days when Unknown was really... whenever they headed the first major, you know, you're playing versus a Toon mid, you sat a fiend, you hear...
Yeah.
Every single wave, dropping his Wraith Band and stuff. It's so annoying.
It's great. He would actually do it for, like, less efficiency. He would, like, drop his Wraith Band as he was taking damage and then, like, put it back on when he was tangoing. But...
Yeah, they play for style points.
Absolutely. I think it's worth it. And Ferev, he's no different. Ready to just run at people. Hook, not going to connect, but nonetheless, they've got heals for days, and Storm Spirit says, you know what, I'm going to party. Get over here maybe next time. Ice Path, not going to connect that time. A little bit off the mark for Thug, and Mid One might just turn his attention onto him as well, but able to dodge away from the dual breath, and Ferev, he doesn't care either. Happy as a clam. God, how do you stop this? Oh, yeah. Ice Path again, not going to connect. Sauce Barton going to get jumped upon as well. Whoa. They've got Ravage. They've got God Strength. GG gets called.
Wow.
No way, no how. Secret take it demonstrably in game number one.
Yeah, they just got massacred.
The Storm took played really, really well that game. Like, he countered a lot of their...